universal testing machine, we are going to conduct a second experiment, bending test. Bending test we are doing on wooden specimen. See, this is a specimen. In this, we are going to conduct a bending test. Now, here, before going to conduct experiment, we have to fix some attachment. These are bending attachment. We have to keep on top of lower crosshead, bottom crosshead, and bending pan, we have to fix bottom of middle crosshead. Now, in this, we are doing three-point bending test, on point load to support load. Now, before going to conduct experiment, I told in tensile test, we have to remove dead weight. Beginning, we have to keep both wall closed condition, left control wall and right control wall. Then, in this display, what reading is showing, tear it, reset it, make it zero. Then, switch on hydraulic pump, open right control wall. Now, load starts increasing, deflection showing zero. When deflection shows values, when it will show 0.1 values, we should switch off pump. Then close right control wall, whatever value is there, remove it. Then after that, you have to mount a specimen. Before that, you have to take some measurement, height of this specimen, width of this specimen. Then you have to keep like this. Span length of this specimen 400 mm. In this, they given numbers near this hole, 4 in the sense, it will be 400 distance, it will indicate. That's why you have to move this attachment on that number, on that 4 number, then insert this pin. Both side you have to do like that. Here also you should move this attachment on 4 number, then insert this pin. After that, keep this specimen on this attachment. Then on this attachment, then both side equal gap should be there. Then by pressing this down switch, you should get contact of that bending pan. Now this specimen mounted rigidly. Now whatever reading is there in this monitor, you have to make it zero. I told this left control valve shouldn't open after removing dead weight. We removed dead weight already. Then switch on hydraulic pump, open right control valve. Load starts increasing. Corresponding this deformation value, every 0.2 deformation, whatever load we are getting, that we have to note down. Now see load applying on specimen, this bottom crosshead moving up. Now if you see here, readings, we are not using any other instruments, we are taking readings from here only. This is the displacement and this is the load. Till breaking point, we have to note down load. Now it is goes on increasing. One point it will break, that time we should stop machine. Specimen broken. Till this, whatever readings are there, that you have to note down. it is enough. Then finally, I have told do calculation, don't want to take measurements from specimen.